I grew up in a very tumultuous household, and reading for me was an escape.
My dad reads, and he always had this ginormous stack of books on his bedside table. I wanted to be like Dad, so that's really where I think I started reading.
Probably high school or even junior high school, I was spending full days in the library.
I actually don't remember my life without books.
I always read when I was younger because I wanted to like discover different parts of the world that I didn't have access to.
Reading was a way into a different world.
Reading keeps you curious because you realize how much you don't know, and you're gentle with yourself when you give yourself permission to not know everything.
Through literature, we're able to be open to different ways of being.
The wonder about books is that you grow with them and they grow with you.
Reading makes me more human. When I read, I connect to those deeper emotions in myself.
I learn how to navigate this world through language.
Books that we read with our children, with our friends, it helps us reveal who we are.
When I walk into someone's house, the first thing I do is walk up to their bookshelf. For me, it's like, who are you?
Reading is intimate, it's quiet, and it's very peaceful.
The thing that I look forward to the most is spending an hour before bed reading every night.
Every year, I challenge myself to read the equivalent of my height in books. I'm 5'5", and I've found that on average, I'm about 75 books tall.
I think I read about a book a day.
I read about 50 books a year.
Never lend me a book. I will ruin it. I highlight every single thing that I come across that speaks to me. When you read, you pick up things that kind of create these little stars in the sky, and then you get to kind of piece together all the constellations that then become your writing and something original that you create.
I tend to gravitate towards a woman who is in any way, shape, or form like me.
I found so much comfort in them just speaking their truth.
Even old books like Anne of Green Gables or something, reading about these strong characters who don't go with the crowd is really inspiring.
Reading books for me is a way of growing, and so a really good book is always going to shift my perspective.
When I read something and it makes me think about an experience differently, that's what I love most about literature.
When I look at this book, I remember the power and the beauty of just trying new things.
The world gives you so much pain, and here you are making gold out of it. There is nothing purer than that.
This is a book before printed books. They were called illuminated manuscripts because they drew pictures in them. Because, of course, anyone seeing them, many people couldn't read.
The Seas by Samantha Hunt. It's about a teenage girl living in a small town, and her reality unfolds in a really fantastical way.
Alone Against North by Adam Schultz. It's this amazing book about this Canadian explorer who explores this unknown river in the Hudson's Bay Lowlands.
The Terrible. To me, it's about addiction. I couldn't put it down. Like, I think I read it in one day. It's poetry.
A Spy in the House of Love. Anais Nin. The first time he looked at her, he felt everything will burn. There's something about that.
From a young age, for a lot of girls, there's this pressure to be good.
You're always sort of pressured to be like so pretty and go with the crowd.
A bad girl is somebody who is herself unapologetically.
Powerful and strong and beautiful.
I don't care what anybody thinks about me. I'm just gonna be me.
How dare you be yourself in this world that tells you to be something else?